It's a big day for the folks who brought Pittsburgh Wiggle Whiskey. Today is the day they are branching out into the cider business. Threadbare Cider House is opening with a big public party tonight. Located in Spring Garden in the north side, the party will be family friendly with hard cider for adults and non-alcoholic cider for children. And get this, before the doors even opened, USA Today named it in a list of 50 cider destinations in the United States. After tonight's grand opening, there will be regular tours, half on the history of Johnny Appleseed, a real person from Pittsburgh, and on the cider making process. Oh, and they serve food too. So enough talking about all of this. We want to taste it and hear with a sample and more on the grand opening. Our Threadbare General Manager, Audra Kelly, along with Executive Chef Jay West. Thank you both for being here.
Thank you for having us.
And Yelp was just on a moment ago, and we actually featured you guys 2 weeks ago. So it was really cool to kind of get a glimpse of what you're doing. And so let's talk about the cider and how did this all come about?
So we were actually at Wiggle, we were kind of experimenting with this regional seasonal seasonal whiskey, and that was our Walkabout, which is really just a crowd favorite. So with that, we were experimenting, and we kind of got down this like rabbit hole of Johnny Appleseed or Johnny Chapman, who was a beloved Pittsburgher that actually he would go around to houses and say, "Good news, fresh from heaven." And he would bring apple seeds. And with that, he actually was this, he loved animals, and he even walked around barefoot because once he stepped on a snake and he killed it. So he took his, he vowed never to wear shoes again. So that is where we kind of fell in love with Johnny Appleseed, and he's actually been described as threadbare. So that is
because of his tattered clothing.
So that is where our name comes from.
That's awesome.
So today let's try the dry first.
Yeah.
So this dry cider can be kind of considered, if you think about it, more like a sparkling white wine.
Oh, nice.
We think that this can take the place of a champagne on your table.
Okay.
By far my favorite of them. And
great, I can't wait to try it. Now, how many different ciders do you have?
So we'll have three core ciders to start. And then from there, we will focus also on experimental and barrel aged ciders.
That is awesome.
As well as meads.
Great, and what is a mead?
So mead is basically a fermented honey.
Oh, sounds fun.
Yeah, okay. And this guy that you're also trying, in terms of the apple, Pittsburgh apple history, this is our like kind of take on that traditional cider that would have been drank during the time of Johnny Appleseed.
It's delicious. And Jay, I want to talk a little bit about the pizzas. This is what we were talking about on Yelp a couple weeks ago, where your pizzas. So what are you going to be offering?
So we have a few items besides pizzas, mostly shared plates, but the one thing that we want to make sure that we focus on is sourcing from local farms. And in addition to use expendables like the yeast from the farmhouse cider, which you'll try in a minute, is actually the yeast I use to ferment the dough.
So nothing goes to waste.
As much as possible, we try to use those things.
Very good. And so what did you bring for us? What pizza is this?
This pizza is a fermented, I'm sorry, it's not fermented. It's a preserved lemon, sweet peppers, and brie.
It would be interesting if it was fermented. That sounds really good. I love brie. And what about this guy over
here?
That
is bacon, apples, sage.
That's great. Now, do you find that you're putting a lot of apples in the food that you're offering just to go with the theme?
They happen to be in season right now,
right.
But yeah, I tried to do that.
That's great. Let's talk about the building, because I was reading a little bit about where you guys are located, and it sounds like it's an amazing facility.
So whenever we were first looking, we were actually looking for a barrel house because we were kind of at capacity where we were before. So this was the building that in front of it was our barrel house. And then it just so happened that this beautiful building was behind it. There's a 10,000 square foot, used to be a tannery.
Oh, okay.
It was kind of the perfect land that we stumbled upon. And it also happens to be just two blocks away from our
Wiggle Whiskey
barrel house.
That's awesome. And okay, so this is, I want to talk about the tours, but you mentioned that there's some family-friendly things going on this weekend. You guys also have a playroom, which is amazing if you're a parent and you want to bring the kids down.
Yeah.
I thought that was really neat.
So it's tucked away in still in the dining room, but there's a nice interactive area that kids can play, and then also that first tour is family friendly on Saturdays.
That's great. And are these going to be weekly tours of the
Saturday?
Okay.
The family friendly tour is at 11:30.
Well, this is really delicious, and I'd love to try the farmhouse as well. And what is this one like?
So the farmhouse is an off dry, and we actually got yeast rather than using a traditional wine yeast or champagne yeast. Mm-hmm. This yeast was actually isolated from a cider press in West England.
Oh, that is so good. I didn't know that I would be a cider fan. I am a huge cider fan. You guys definitely turned. This is so good. What else is going on at your building at the Cider House that people would want to know about? During the tours, you're going to walk people around and kind of show them how the process works.
Yeah, so during the tour,
right?
It's basically the tour is half history, half production.
Okay.
And those are kind of intertwined with each other. So you start in the tasting room and dining room, and then you get to walk along a catwalk that will overlook the production space.
That's awesome.
And then from there, you get to go downstairs and actually see the production space.
Great stuff. Thank you so much for coming on and telling us a little bit. And congratulations to you guys. And again, Threadbare Cider House opens to the public tonight from 7 until 9. Tickets are $30. They include drinks, food, and the tour. Regular hours and tours start on Saturday, and you'll find Threadbare at 1291 Spring Garden Avenue in Spring Hill on the north side.